So we are going to start sole of the foot. Okay, we are done with thigh, like everything. Now we are moving to sole. Okay, so that is also called as plantar aspect. Now when you just describe, so if you just recollect what we have done in the dissection hall, how does the skin of the sole look? It is thick, hairless, and it has no pigmentation, isn't it? So it has lot of sweat glands, and it is firmly bound down to the underlying deep fascia by numerous fibrous bands. Okay, so we will see, once we reflect the skin, we will see the plantar aponeurosis, and it will show like in the palm, same like palm only, but it will be much thicker than palm. Okay, so it shows creases. Of course, the creases are very much clearly demarcated in the palm. So many creases we don't usually see. Of course, in cadaver, so many like shrinking will be there. So much of shrinkage will be there, because of which folds may be seen. Okay. Then subcutaneous tissue, if you recollect, lot of fat we have seen, isn't it? Subcutaneous tissue contains a lot of fat, especially in the heel region. Okay. That means it is acting as a cushion. Then when you see, it is extremely sensitive to touch. That means when you are not getting up, sometimes your mom, she will tickle it, isn't it, to wake you up, something. That means it is very sensitive to touch, because it has lot of free nerve endings. Okay, what are the nerves which are going into the sole, which we have seen? Which nerve is this on the medial aspect? Which nerve in the posterior compartment you are seeing? Hema? Ritika?
Tibial nerve.
Tibial nerve passes through which retinaculum? Can you name this retinaculum on medial side?
Flexor retinaculum.
Very good. Flexor retinaculum passes through flexor retinaculum to come into the sole. So what are the terminal divisions of tibial nerve? Medial and lateral plantar nerves. Of course, we have many cutaneous nerves also, which are responsible for this tickling sensation. Okay, nerve endings are there, which make sole sensitive to surfaces that are bogged down. Okay, now let us see what are the various cutaneous nerves. Now, just now, as Hema told us, basically the chief nerves, the tibial nerve finally terminates into two. That is the medial plantar nerve and lateral plantar nerve. Apart from that, we have most medial aspect is supplied by saphenous nerve, and laterally it is supplied by sural nerve. Saphenous nerve, sural nerve, all these things we will discuss when we do lumbar plexus and sacral plexus. They are the branches of femoral nerve, we will see. Then behind, in the heel region, you will see the medial calcaneal branch of tibial nerve. Okay, so this is the cutaneous nerve supply of the sole. Okay, these are the cutaneous nerves. Now, once you remove the skin, we have done this dissection, we have removed the skin. Once the skin was removed, we have seen a lot of fat was there. It was so thick, isn't it? Skin itself was so thick. You had to work hard so much to remove, cut this skin, thick skin. Then you had to chop so much of fat. Once you chop out the fat, then you have seen there is a structure which is quite again thick enough. Okay, which is called as plantar aponeurosis. Okay, so it lies beneath the subcutaneous tissue and surrounds the intrinsic foot muscles. That means still foot muscles are not visible, because we know, like, below this plantar aponeurosis we have the plant, like sole muscles, muscles of soles in various levels. Like, we will see what are the layers, four layers. Okay, now when you see this plantar aponeurosis, it is thicker in the central part, and usually it is thinner as it is towards the margins. Okay, so below this we will have intrinsic muscles. Okay, so the intrinsic muscles we will see, like flexor digitorum brevis. Okay, that will be seen in the first layer, flexor digitorum minimi. They are actually, that means first layer muscles are actually taking origin from this plantar aponeurosis. Okay, then so this thick central part is nothing but the plantar aponeurosis. What is the name of this bone we have?
Calcaneum.
So it is, if you just look, it has a triangle, apex is towards the calcaneum, and how many slips it is splitting into? How many slips the palmar aponeurosis has split?
Five.
Palmar, four slips, because we needed free movement of the thumb, opposition. Such opposition is not so freely possible with big toe, great toe, isn't it? Why is that? Because if you just look at this plantar aponeurosis, it will be splitting into 5 slips. That means one slip is going towards the big toe, because of which you will see the great toe doesn't have free movement. It has restricted movement because it is receiving one slip, as the other toes are also receiving the slips. Okay, that is. So this plantar aponeurosis is triangular. It is protecting the underlying muscles, vessels and nerves. Okay, you can see the muscles in between these slips. We also see the vessels and nerves in the following pictures. We can see. So this is apex, and if you just consider it as a triangle, this is base and this is apex. So apex is towards calcaneum. We know this is the medial tubercle and this is the lateral tubercle of calcaneum. Base is dividing into 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 slips, okay, which are going into each toe. So each slip, now see, suppose this is only one slip, it will be further dividing into superficial and deep slips, okay. So superficial one, obviously the one which is close to the skin, you call it as superficial, and the deep slip will be going towards the deeper component, that means towards the bone, metatarsals, like that. Okay, so each slip, it has superficial band which is attached to the skin, fat and all, deep band which is passing to the root of the toes, where it divides into two. That means further the deep slip will be splitting into two. Okay, so diverging along the flexor tendons. That means as you remove this, the you will see the deeper part of the plantar aponeurosis. Then you will see it will be diverging along the flexor tendons and fusing with the fibrous flexor sheaths, what we have seen even in the upper limb. Fibrous flexor sheaths, okay, which will be surrounding the flexor digitorum longus, flexor digitorum profundus, we have seen, isn't it? So that was surrounding those, we had fibrous flexor sheaths, nothing but synovial sheaths, okay, which prevent the friction and give lubrication. Similarly, in the sole, in the foot, here in the toes, whatever tendons are entering, they are well protected by this fibrous flexor sheaths. Okay, and as we move on, you will see there will be thickening between the metatarsal bones, which are actually called as transverse ligaments, deep transverse ligaments, which is also one of the modification of the deep band of plantar aponeurosis. Okay, then now see here, this is completely plantar aponeurosis. This is the medial border, okay, and this is the lateral border, okay. So they are actually, when you just see in if you remove this plantar aponeurosis, inside you will have fibrous septa. That means from medial border you will have one fibrous septa. Suppose this is plantar aponeurosis, this is medial septa, this is lateral septa, okay. That means we have two septa, that is medial and lateral borders of the thick aponeurosis are continuous with thinner deep fascia covering abductors of big toe and abductors of little toe. Okay, from each of these borders, we know like fibrous septa are passing superiorly.